Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, Gerard Kaker! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner, Kevin Francis!
They say my whole hood got it under investigation. They know they talk that stick talk, that stick talk. They know we talk that lick talk, that lick talk. $10 million cash, fuck a friend. Started sipping syrup, I've been geeked there since. Gotta keep that heat on the seat air since. You know we talk that stick talk, that stick talk. I'm about to fuck this cash up on a new toy. About to fuck this cash up on a new toy. You can't understand us, cause you're too soft. Tell the bad bands, run them straight through the machinery. They came through with a stick, and you heard it. They came through in this bitch and never swerved. I can't believe the blood ain't on my shirt. Because he got hit.
Ladies and gentlemen, this next bout is sanctioned by Florida Combative Sports and is brought to you by 72 Hour Print, your one-stop print shop. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner to my left, weighing in tonight at 170 pounds, making his MMA debut. He trains and fights out of Martial Arts University. Ladies and gentlemen, Gerard Kachor! And his opponent, fighting out of the blue corner to my right, weighing in at 170 pounds, also making his MMA debut. He trains and fights out of Fight Team LLC. Ladies and gentlemen, Kevin Francis! Your referee calling all the action, Dave Baggett.
All right, so we are here with the third fight of the night, a fight between Gerard Kachor and Kevin Francis being fought at 170. Francis making his debut as well as Kachor, both these guys in the cage for the first time. For this fight, I'm being joined by my cohort there at cagezombies.com, Mr. Sean Walker.
Evening, everybody.
We got Kevin Francis in blue and Gerard Kachor in red. Francis just coming out and throwing haymakers, but big height difference between these two fighters. That's going to go a long way for the reach of Francis trying to reach up there and land a lot of shots to Kachor. So we'll see how that works out for the both of them, really. Kachor having a big reach advantage and Francis with a big disadvantage. But thus far, doesn't seem to be the issue because when they're throwing punches, they seem to be pretty close to each other and they're getting in there and just throwing. So we'll see, though, as the fight plays out here, just how it goes.
Keeps getting right in on him, trying to take him down. Oh.
Oh.
not a lot of technique here, but both guys putting on a pretty good fight so far. Being pretty, they're picking. They're not just kind of, they're not throwing randomly. They're picking their shots pretty good. I've seen Francis a couple times do the takedown like that. This is the first time he's actually, well, I was going to say the first time he's actually gone to the ground. He seems to be interested in getting the takedowns, picking Kachor up and tossing him down, but not doing anything with it. So at most he might be scoring points by doing it, but the points are only going to go so far when you're not following him to the ground and actually trying to show some work there. Simply just tossing him down looks cool. The fans enjoy it, but I don't think it's going to score a lot with the judges if you're not going with him and showing some sort of grappling ability or jiu-jitsu work.
Francis was actually trying to hold him down there that time, and Kachor just got right back up. Oh.
Yeah, you can see Francis really wants nothing to do with going to the ground. He just wants to toss him down. Seems to be having a shin pad issue, though. That shin pad's coming off the right foot. The second fight in a row with a shin pad malfunction, so we'll see if that plays an effect.
Leaving the cage.
When you toss your opponent down like that, it looks cool, it sounds cool, you hear the fans like to see that, but in reality with mixed martial arts, it's not doing much. It might be tiring him a little bit. I think Kachor is getting a little bit worn out by that. Obviously nobody who gets thrown to the ground repeatedly is going to enjoy it, but I think that Francis needs to do a bit more with that in order to really score some points and really to show off his ability. He comes out of a school over at Fight Team where we've seen some good fighters. Rashawn Action Jackson trains out of that camp. So they've got a good repertoire over there, and they obviously, their guys know what they're doing. So I'd like to potentially see Francis do a little bit with those. I mean, when he tosses them down, follow him to the ground, try to show us a little bit of jiu-jitsu, show us some grappling. It'd be cool to see a little bit about what he can work with. We'll see what happens here in this second round.
Like these takedowns are starting to actually take their effect on Francis.
Yeah, those
looking a little winded now.
Yeah, those last couple, you could see he tossed him down and then really was just kind of like not sure what to do, and he kind of backed off a little bit. But you see both guys breathing heavy. Both guys have their mouth hanging open. We'll get into the second round here. Now, we do three-minute rounds here in amateur MMA, so a total of 9 minutes in the cage for these amateur fighters. Big leg kick that takes Kachor to the ground pretty quickly. Francis continuing to struggle with that right shin pad, though. Got to be careful. Kachor's got to be careful. That was dangerously close. If you're getting tossed to the ground, man, bring those arms in. Do not put that arm back to try and plant. I've seen multiple times that arm get snapped. So if you're getting tossed down, just take that brunt. Take the brunt of that with your back.
Oh.
Now that's out. He's out.
He's done.
Yeah. Wow.
Two clean punches.
Yeah.
What an explosive end of that fight.
Yeah, two, as Sean said, two very clean punches straight to the face of Kachor there for what is a it was a beautiful knockout. Had him out on his feet. Anytime the dude's out and he's still standing, just kind of hovering,
yeah.
it's a beautiful thing.
He was out with that first one. The second one was just icing on the cake. Glad to see he's up and responsive. Medics are taking a look at him.
I saw some good stuff from Kevin Francis. You know, it was a good fight. He put on a good fight. I'd like to see him maybe get more comfortable with the groundwork. Maybe that's the issue. But he obviously has good power. He's got power in his punches. He's got power in his takedowns. He's able to pick his opponent up who's outsized him heavily. You know, big, tall, awkward like that, pick him up and be able to drop him as many times as he did. So he knows what he's doing. But I'd like to see him follow his opponent to the ground, demonstrate some jiu-jitsu, some grappling ability, and maybe take his game to the next level. But really good stuff for who I believe is a debut fighter. So good fight from him. And we'll go to Sideshow now for the in-ring announcement on the time and official method of victory.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner of this bout, 1 minute and 1 second, in the second round by way of knockout, fighting out of the blue corner, Kevin Francis!
On a new toy, fuck this cash up on